Hey, what's up, guys? My name is Sam. I'm a photographer and filmmaker based here in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. And if you're new here, welcome. Here we talk about street photography, we talk about film photography, as well as building a career as a freelance photographer and filmmaker. So this is a follow-up video to a video that I did last Wednesday talking about how you can start earning money as a beginner photographer. And one of the tips that I mentioned was to build your portfolio on Instagram. And I had a question asking, how do we build a portfolio if you are a beginner photographer? And I totally understand that question. And it makes a lot of sense to ask because, you know, you need to have a portfolio before you get hired. But then if you don't get hired, you don't really have a portfolio. So how do you go about that, especially if you have zero experience taking professional photos? So today I want to talk about three things that you can do to build your portfolio as a beginner photographer. So the first thing I want to share with you is actually thinking about what you want to be hired for and going out there and looking for those images. For example, let's say you want to be a portrait or a fashion photographer. It's actually going out there and looking for fashion related or portrait related content that you can shoot. Something that you need to change your mind a little bit is that not every image in your portfolio has to be a professional image. And when I mean professional image, is that something that somebody paid you for to do. Your portfolio is you, so it can be anything that's related to what you do or what you want to be hired for. As long as it looks good, put it in your portfolio, it's fine. So going back to the example of if you want to be a fashion or a portrait photographer looking for opportunities to shoot, this could be through Insta meets or maybe photography Facebook groups. Or maybe just going out with your friends to go and take some images that you want to be hired for. Fashion, portrait, doesn't matter. But it's about you actually taking the steps to going out and shooting and getting images to put in your portfolio, because you have zero experience. Nobody's going to hire you. So you got to make the legwork to make these shoots happen so that you can actually get the work for it. So I'll give you a real world example of what I actually did. So currently I'm on a project for interior shots, interior architecture shots. And prior to this, I actually didn't have any sort of architecture or any sort of interior related images. I had maybe one or two, but it wasn't enough. So what I did was I actually went to, before I actually got the job, was I actually went to wherever I went to a hotel, or if I was scouting locations for another job, I would actually take shots of interior photos in the hotel rooms and actually put that up as my portfolio. Even though these images weren't commissioned images, I still put them in my portfolio, because ultimately as a portfolio, the main thing you need to understand is people just want to see if you are able to get the shots that they want. That's all. Are you capable of doing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or whatever their requirements are? And that's what your portfolio should be. You should be able to show people that, hey, I can do this, 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 this. You don't have to monetize it, but you're putting it in your portfolios to show people that, hey, I can do this. And that's really what people want to see in your portfolio. Obviously, the list that I mentioned is very small, and there are so many other genres of photography for you to actually explore. And that's why going to my second tip is shoot everything that you possibly can. Come up with a list of things that people can potentially hire you for, and actually going out and take those pictures. Yes, the first tip was to kind of like specialize, because that's much easier for you to kind of like have your head in the game and plan out, hey, I want this, 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 this. Because what I see a lot of young photographers do is that they don't know what to do, they don't have the clarity. And if you don't plan out, nothing's gonna happen. But once you kind of have planned out, you kind of have a couple of images, the next step is to just do everything else. Shoot whatever happens. So I'll give you another real world example. I actually shoot for an international organization here in Malaysia, and one of the jobs that I have to do is actually street photography, still life here in Malaysia or everyday life in Malaysia. I'm actually doing a kind of photography that I actually love to do, and people are actually paying me for it. And it all started because I had a couple of images that are related to what they're looking for in my street photography portfolio. And that's why it's very important for you to just go out and shoot whatever you possibly can, that if you remotely think that it can be monetized, take it. Another real world example that I want to mention is that I used to be big into like this fashion photography and filmmaking. So what I did was I did a couple of spec fashion shoots with some friends. And I think I did about last year and nothing came out of it. But recently, about a couple of weeks ago, a client approached me and saying, hey, do you have any examples of work that you can do? I dug out a couple of things that I shot prior, like a year ago, and I gave it to them and they hired me. So that's an example of just shooting whatever you can possibly think of shooting and actually going out and getting it and then just keeping it in your portfolio, because you never know when the opportunity might arise. As a freelancer, yes, you might be inclined to shoot weddings, you might be inclined to shoot specific things, but as a freelancer, you know, you're not gonna say no to money, especially when times are tough. So if you've had prior work that you've already done, it's much easier to get hired because you don't actually have to go out and take a new set of images. You already have a portfolio mentioned. And that's why tip number two, really, once you have kind of idea of what you want to shoot, shoot everything else and keep it in your portfolio. And the third thing I want to talk about is actually preparing your portfolio. So there are two things that you can do. Number one is posting on Instagram, and number two is actually creating a PDF if you don't have a website. So I want to talk about the easy one, which is posting on Instagram. So ideally, your Instagram should be of things that you want to be hired for. For example, if you want to be hired in fashion photography, post mostly fashion or portrait related. If you want to be a music photographer, post mainly music related content. Or if you want to be a wedding photographer, post mainly wedding photography related content. Because when people are scrolling through Instagram, it's much easier to show them, hey, I do this, I do this, I do this. And people are much more inclined to hire you because they've already set. However, Instagram is not really an accurate place because there are going to be a lot of situations where people are going to hire you, especially corporate clients, and they're going to say like, hey, do you have a portfolio? Please, please don't show them your Instagram. If a corporate client hires you or contacts you, please don't show them Instagram. I've had so many beginner photographers do this and it's so unprofessional. And so if you can't post on Instagram, what do? Build a PDF. And I know some of you are going to say, oh my god, building a PDF is going to be very difficult. It's actually not. Go to Canva and there are a lot of templates where you can do. So categorize your portfolio based on the images that you shot. For example, food, weddings, portraiture, street. One page should be of one category. Don't have multiple pages for multiple categories. Just have one page, this, weddings, another page, street, another page, events, and so on and so on. And this is a lot more professional when you're dealing with corporate clients because you can just email them your PDF and then just show them like, hey, I have this, 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 this. And it's much better than just showing them your Instagram, assuming that you do not have a website. If there is only one thing that you can take back from this video, it would be this. Not all your images on your portfolio have to be from paid work. It can be your own personal work, personal projects, because once again, the idea of having a portfolio is actually showing people that you can do XYZ. Do you have to put in the legwork to build your portfolio because you have no experience? You have nothing to show people that would get them to hire you, and that's why you're gonna make it happen for yourself. Take photos that could potentially be something that people will hire you for, and that's how you build your portfolio. That's how I started building my portfolio, and right now I have a pretty large portfolio because I've been doing it for a while already. But when I started, it was just about whatever free opportunity that I could get. In uni, I would go take photos of events. I would take photos of my friends. I would take photos of whatever I could possibly get my hands on, and that's just how I built my portfolio. So yeah, I hope this video helped you as a beginner photographer. If you have any more questions, please do let me know in the comments below, or drop me an email, or drop me a message on Instagram. I'll be more than happy to help you. If you like this video, drop a like and a subscribe. It really, really helps out the channel, the YouTube algorithm. I'm really trying to take YouTube a lot more seriously right now. If you have any more questions related to photography, street, or film, please do let me know. I'll be more than happy to cover them. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.